Hello students, I am Kiran Shinde, Assistant Professor in IICMR MCA department. Welcome to the video lecture on subnetting. In this video lecture, we are going to understand how to subnet a class C network and a class B network. Let us first start with a class C network address as 210.129.41.0. First of all, we have to recall the default mask of class C, which is 255.255.255.0. Which means the first 3 octets, that is 24 bits, are reserved for network portion, and last 8 bits, that is the last octet, which is reserved for the host portion. Along with this, we have to recall the 2 formulae which are used to find out the number of subnets and to find out the number of hosts. So number of subnets is equal to 2 raised to n, and number of hosts is equal to 2 raised to n minus 2. Now with this information, we will try to subnet this class C network into 14 usable subnets. So to subnet this class C network into 14 usable subnets, first of all we have to think how many bits should we borrow from the host portion of this class C network. So first of all we will try borrowing 3 bits. So if we put n is equal to 3, our formula is 2 raised to n to find out the number of subnets, it will give us 8, and which is not enough to subnet this particular class C into 14 subnets. So we will try putting n is equal to 4. It will give us 2 raised to 4 is equal to 16 usable subnets, which is more than enough. So here we understand that we have to borrow 4 bits from the host portion in order to subnet this class C network into 14 usable subnets. So the network octet in binary will look like this. The last octet will be divided into 4 bits for subnetting, and remaining 4 bits will be used for the host portion. So with this, we get number of hosts as, by putting the value of n is equal to 4 in the formula, 2 raised to n minus 2 is equal to 14 usable hosts per subnet. So up to this point we have understood that we are requiring 4 bits for subnetting, and remaining 4 bits are left for the host portion. Now let us continue and find out the first subnetwork address. So to find out the first usable subnet address, again we have to concentrate on the last octet where subnetting has happened, and essentially we will focus on the first 4 bits of the last octet, and we will write the binary equivalent of 1 in the first 4 bits of this last octet, and after that we will convert this entire octet into decimal, then we will get 16. So entirely the first usable subnet address will be 210.129.41.16. After this, we want to calculate the first usable host on the first subnet. So here, if we focus on the last 4 bits which are left for the host portion, we have to write the binary equivalent of 1 in the last 4 bits, and then convert the entire octet into decimal, we will get 17. But there is one more way with which you can very well easily find out the first usable host. You have to just add 1 into the first usable subnet address to find out the first usable host. So here we get it as 210.129.41.17. After this, we want to find out second usable host. Again, keep on adding, we will get 18, and continuing like this, we get the last usable host on the first subnet as 210.129.41.30. And of course, as we know, a broadcast address is nothing but all ones in the host portion. If you just concentrate on this last 4 bits, there are all ones in this last 4 bits. So entirely if you convert this octet, you get 31 as the broadcast address for the first usable subnet address. Let us continue. Now we will find out the second usable subnet address. Again we have to concentrate on the first 4 bits of the last octet and write down the binary equivalent of 2. Convert the entire bit or entire octet into the decimal value, you will get 32. And so this is the second usable subnet address, that is 210.129.41.32. Similarly, we will find out the third usable subnet, and so on. We find out the last usable subnet address, which will be 210.129.41.224. Now here you have to remember 2 things, exactly which will be the last usable subnet. Now as per the problem, we are asked to subnet this class C network into 14 usable subnets. So you might find out the 14th subnet address as the last one, or you can find out the total number of subnets are 16. So 16th can be the last subnet address. So here we have found out it is nothing but the 14th subnet address in the given problem, which comes out to be 210.129.41.224. Now the last thing is, we need to find out the subnet mask for the given problem. It is very simple to find out. Again, we have to write the default mask with 255.255.255. Just concentrate on the last octet. Here, the first four bits of the last octet are all ones, which are denoted by subnetwork bits, and the last four bits are host bits. So now convert this entire octet into decimal. You will get 240. So your mask will be 255.255.255.240. So here we come to the end of the class C subnetting problem. Let us move further. Now consider a class B network address as 152.178.0.0. Now in this problem, again we have to recall the subnet default subnet mask or default mask of this particular class, which is 255.255.0.0. It means first two octets are reserved for network portion and last two octets are reserved for host portion. Now in this problem, we are asked to subnet this class B network into 80 usable subnets. So again, first of all, we have to decide how many bits do we borrow for the subnetting purpose. So again, try borrowing n is equal to 6, which will give you 64 subnets. Now 64 subnets are not enough because we are asked to subnet 80 different networks. So here we will try borrowing n is equal to 7. It will give you 128 subnets, which is quite enough. So up to this, we have understood that for subnetting this class B network into 80 usable subnets, we will require 7 bits. Now again, observe the network octet in binary. Now here, out of this 16 host bits, we are going to use 7 bits for subnet and now remaining 9 bits for the host portion. So here we will get number of hosts per subnet as, by putting the formula 2 raised to n minus 2, n is equal to 9, 2 raised to 9 minus 2 is equal to 510, that is 510 usable hosts per subnet. With this information, we will find the first subnet address. So again, follow the same way. Now concentrate here on the 7 bits from the 16 total host bits, because here we have used 7 bits for the subnet portion. So now we have to write binary equivalent of 1 in terms of 7 bits and then convert this entire octet into decimal. We will get 152.178.2.0. Continuing similarly, we will find out the first usable host. Now finding out first usable host, you have to concentrate on the 9 bits which are left for the host portion and write down the binary equivalent of 1 in the last 9 bits and then convert the entire octet. But here the crucial step is, while converting this, you have to remember that the third octet is nothing but the previous subnet address which you have received, that is .2. And after that, you have to convert the last octet, which you will get 1 as the last one. So the first usable host on the first subnet will be 152.178.2.1. Continuing like this, you will get the second host. And like this, you are going to follow the same process. You will get last usable host on the first subnet. Now again here, you have to think, when you find out the last usable host, you have to see the 9 bits which are left for the host portion. After resetting 1 bit as 0, you will get the last usable host. Why? Because all of us know that for finding out the broadcast address of any network, you have to set all the host bits as 1. So essentially, the second last address in this particular subnet, by resetting 1 bit as 0, you will get the last usable host on the first subnet. So continuing like this, we will get the second usable host. Again, concentrate on the 7 bits. Write down the binary equivalent of 2 in terms of 7 bits and then convert the octet. You will get 4, 152.178.4.0. Continuing like this, you will get all the subnets. And finally, we will find out the subnet mask. Here, again, write down the default mask as 255.255. Now concentrate on the last two octets. This third octet, which is used here, from which we have used 7 bits for the subnet. So we have written 7 ones and the last 0 as it is, and of course the last portion, that is the last octet for host as it is. And now after converting this third octet, we will get 255.255.254.0. This is the subnet mask we received after subnetting this class B network into 80 different subnets. Hope you understood.